we can organize for you to visit the Jewish ghetto. Would you do it? If you do, to the Jewish ghetto in Warsaw, I will go with you. So I will be sure that you will be as safe as possible. A few days later, we established contact. By that time, Jewish ghetto, as it existed in 1942 until July, did not exist anymore. Out of approximately 400,000 Jews, in the meantime, some 300,000 were already deported from the ghetto. So within the outside walls, practically there were some four units. The most important was the so-called the central ghetto. They were separated by some areas inhabited by the Aryans already, some areas not inhabited by anybody. There was some building. This building was constructed in such a way that the wall which separated the ghetto from the outside world was a part of the back of the building. So the front was facing the Aryan area. There was some tunnel. We went through this tunnel without any kind of difficulties. What struck me, completely different man. The Bund leader, the Polish nobleman. I go with him. He is broken down, curbing like a Jew from the ghetto, as if he lived there all the time. Apparently this was his nature. This was his world. So we walked the streets. He was on my left. We didn't talk very much. He led me. Well, so what? So now comes the description of it, yes? Naked bodies on the street. I ask him, why are they here?
Corpses, you mean?
Corpses. Says, well, they have a problem. If the Jew dies and the family wants some burial, they have to pay tax on it. So they just throw them in the street.
Because they cannot pay the tax.
Yeah. They cannot afford it. So then they say, every rag counts. So they take their clothing. And then once the body, the corpse, is on the street, yes, Judenrat has to take care of it. Women with their babies. Publicly feeding their babies. But they have no breast, it's just flat. Babies with some crazy eyes looking.
Did it look like a complete strange world?
What?
Other world, I mean.
it was not a world. This was not humanity. Streets full. Apparently all of them lived in the street. Exchange, what was the most important? Everybody offering something to sell. 3 onions, pie onions, some cookies, selling, begging each other, crying, I'm hungry. It was horrible, children. Some children running by themselves, or with their mothers sitting. It wasn't humanity. It was some hell. Now, this part of the ghetto, German offices were there in the central ghetto. If Gestapo released somebody, and Gestapo officers, they had to pass through the ghetto to get out of it. So there were also Germans, German traffic. Now, the Germans in uniform, they were walking, silence. Everybody frozen until he passed. No movement, no begging, nothing. Germans, contempt. This is those apparently dirty subhuman. They are not human, this. Now, at a certain point, some movement starts. Jews are running from the street I was on. We jumped into some house. He just hits the door, open the door, open the door. They open the door. We moved in. Windows give to the back of the street. We go to the opposite, in the door. Some woman opened the door. Says, all right, don't be afraid. We are Jews. He pushes me to the window. Look at it, look at it. There were 2 boys. Nice looking boys. Hitlerjugend uniforms. They walked. Every step they made, Jews disappearing, running away. They were talking to each other. At a certain point, a boy gets to his pocket without even thinking. Shoots. Some broken glass, some shouting, The other voice, something, congratulating him. They go back. So I was paralyzed. So then a Jewish woman, probably she recognized me, I don't know that I'm not a Jew. She embraced me, go, it doesn't do you any good, go. So we left the house. Then we left the ghetto. So then he said, you didn't see everything, you didn't see too much. Would you like to go again? I will go with you. I want you to see everything. I will. Next day we went again. The same house, the same way. So then again, now I was more conditioned. So I felt other things. Stench. Dirt, stench. Everywhere, suffocating. Dirty streets. Nervousness, tension. Some bedlam. This was Plac Muranowski. In a corner of it, some children play something with some rags, throwing the rags to another. He says, they are playing, as you see. Life goes on. So then I said, they are simulating playing, they don't play.
It was a special place for playing?
In the corner of Plac Muranowski. No, open. So I say they
are... There were trees?
There were a few trees, rachitic trees. So then we just walked the streets. We didn't talk to anybody. We walked probably 1 hour. Sometime he would tell me, looked at this Jew, a Jew standing without moving. I said, is he dead? He says, no, he's alive. Mr. Witold, remember, he's dying. Look at him. Tell them. You saw it, don't forget. We walk again. It's macabre. Only from time to time, he would whisper, remember this? Or he would tell me, look at her. Very many cases. I would say, what are they doing here? His answer. They are dying. That's all right. They are dying. Then always. But remember? We spent more, perhaps 1 hour. We left the ghetto. Frank and I couldn't take it more. Get me out of it. And then I never saw him again.